parking lot and I recognize all the cars as being people who are neuro-poor people, that feels like I'm in the right place. Hi, I'm Deanna Price. I am the Senior Director of the Pharmacology and Neuroscience.
I am working with a bunch of awesome scientists who dedicated their life and they are dedicating their life towards the drug discovery.
We most at this point have been focused on Parkinson's disease, but we have interest in other neurodegenerative disorders where there currently are no disease-modifying therapeutics. You see these common underlying themes in disease pathology with protein aggregation, decreases in housekeeping mechanisms, and then inflammation. And pretty much any neurodegenerative disorder that you go to look at has these common elements. So we, as a group, are focused on characterizing those aspects of animal models. We are very interested in looking for functional, potentially translatable endpoints. You need to have a very good hold on what the actions of your compound are before you move into the clinic. I think the catwalk is probably one of the most sophisticated pieces of equipment that I've seen, and I'm really, really excited that we have it.
I just stare at the machine and I'm like, this is brilliant. Being able to see the animal going across and seeing how the data, how it comes across, how simple it is to work with.
It gives you so much data that has so much relevance towards the clinical endpoints.
Part of why I'm so excited about it is if you look towards the clinic in terms of what's been enabled by technology, there's a lot of wearable technology that's being implemented in the clinic to assess gait and balance in certain disease populations, including Parkinson's disease. And so if you look at what those endpoints are coming from the clinic, they're really recapitulated in terms of what we are enabled to collect with the catwalk. If you imagine that we have tools like the catwalk and we have tools like a transgenic mouse model of a certain disorder, in the absence of collaborative knowledge, a collaborative knowledge base, I think there's a real challenge in using those tools appropriately.
Now we are incorporating more technology into everything. The future challenge and the current challenge is how we can incorporate it in our drug discovery programs and how it can translate to the endpoints in clinic.